One of the points that you make in the book is that the way forward also has to do with leaders changing the way that they think about business. And you describe a framework that you call the PENTAD.
Right. So as you're indicating, one of the biggest challenges for leaders and for the people they lead is that we have very old ways of thinking in our head. They come from our education system, our parenting system. Most of us who have grown up in the baby boomers and beyond have grown up with a behavioral model of incentives. You know, you get people to do certain things and they get a token or a gold star or eventually big bucks for doing it. Human beings are inspired and have their own inner motivation. And it can drive a very different set of working that's non-fragmented. And I wanted to provide a framework that is systemic in how it works. And part of this was driven by, I literally walked into a bookstore in Menlo Park, California called Kepler's one day, and I was walking around their business table, and I noticed how many subjects they had on there with consultants' names who were on them, and how many different programs were being driven into a part of the company. And that was driving people working first, some out of behavioral models, some out of lists. They had a million different methodologies they were using, which was fragmenting the company further. And I said, my goodness, I look at this and these are all related, but people don't have any way of seeing the relationship. So I put up a PENTAD, which is an old Greek word for me, meaning a dynamic five. Doesn't mean five, it means a dynamic related five. And that starts with always something external. And in fact, all five of them, you'll see, I keep trying to get the mind to go outside, not inside the business, not to measure inside, but to measure outside, not to just divide things up inside, but to make them whole from outside. And I started with, said that if you're in business, then you have a job to customers, consumers, or you may be a B2B, so you have responsibility to a distributor, or maybe even a chain of them, depending back how far back up line you go. And you have responsibility for the quality of their life. Not just the quality of life of your employees, but the people you're serving. How, and not just preventing them from getting a car that's bad, but you have a responsibility to think about their life. That's a part of responsibility. Now, once you see that, you have something to connect what I call the co-creators. I don't like the term employees and suppliers because that, again, fragments them. There's the customers out there and then their employees, and then even way further beyond us, the suppliers. So if you think about the co-creators are really co-creating something for that customer or consumer, and you want to wrap all work systems, all management systems, all pay and progression systems, all hiring systems, everything so that those people become responsible directly for the customer outside. So again, responsibility gets linked. And it's not people who are inside in a hierarchy telling you because they've interpreted what the customer needs, but we set up teams so that they're wrapped around, like in Colgate-Palmolive in Europe, what we did is wrap teams around particular distribution groups. So you had mom and pop grocery stores, and we had teams who were off of the toothpaste line and detergent line and the lines that were making deodorant, and they were wrapped around those mom and pop grocery stores, and they had a mixture of everything from R&D to the line operators, and they had to find a way to improve the capability of the mom and pop grocery store to be viable because there was another team which were wrapped around the big box stores like Carrefour. Now, if you have people, those co-creators connected, they're responsible for them, they become champions for them, now you've got something really working with your customer. But you also then have to do it in a way that's regenerative, that's ecologically sound, that is whole. And so you charter those co-creative teams with doing it in a way that improves the ecosystem of everything that you make and how you touch it. So now we've got the co-creator standing here at one point on this PENTAD, and they're looking outward at the customer, but they're saying, oh, but how we do it has got to really improve the vitality, the viability of everything that we touch in that system and evolve its own capacity. And by the way, the next point on that PENTAD is we do those in communities where humans live. And so we want to keep this ecological thing of which the communities are really nested in, but to make it clear, I pull them apart. So we have to ask, what's the essence, uniqueness, distinctive, and the story of the place in the communities we do business? And you charter the co-creative teams with responsibility now. So now they're responsible for the customer, and the way they're going to do it is to create ecological health and communities which are healthy and vital, and you don't do anything that degrades the community, and you do everything that lifts it up. And then the final point on the PENTAD is the investor. And what they need is an enduring return that is ethically based. And so what you, if you do it in this sequence, if you actually start with customers and you do something that makes their life whole, and the co-creators are connected to that, and they do it in a way that they're ecologically evolving something and keeping communities healthy, what you get are investors getting a huge return because you've got loyalty up the kazoo of everybody in that system. What's interesting, and I have a whole chapter in the book about what happens when you do that backwards.
Okay.
So when you go backwards, you undo it. So if you go after only returns, what you do is get communities who are usually fighting you, not wanting you there, because they can see you don't care about them. You end up having to undercut things and cut costs and, you know, do what you need to look right to do the ecology. Employees and suppliers get to be the name again and their cost of doing business. And pretty soon you've got a loss of loyalty among your customers and consumers. So you want to get the thing spinning in the right direction. And when you do it that way, and I've seen it, the stories in the book are ones I lived with my clients for, you know, almost 40 years now. And when you spin it that direction, it makes the system whole, and it's not that hard.